Now I'm going to do this. I'm going to give you a list of names of people and things and ask you to give me your off-the-cuff reaction to them, what your first thought is. Now, I know that originally you were a beekeeper. And when I say beekeeping to you, what is your initial reaction?
Initial reaction to beekeeping? Oh, I don't know. I would say beekeeping gives me an initial reaction of a lot of hard work, but a lot of excitement. You know, it's a bit of a gamble, beekeeping. It depends on the season, on the weather, as to what sort of honey crop you're going to get. Mm-hmm. You work extremely hard. We used to work 7 days a week for, from dawn to dusk during the honey season. But there's always a bit of a challenge in it. There's a bit of an adventure, and you may not make a great deal of money out of it, mm-hmm. but at least you do have this sense of doing something rather unusual, and there's always the sense of, you just can't always predict exactly what's going to occur.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now what about the abominable snowman?
Well, I think my reaction is now definitely that this whole story is mythological. Mm-hmm. We went into this very carefully on my last expedition, examined all the evidence, and we got a perfectly reasonable explanation, we feel, to all the evidence that appeared, like such as tracks, yeti scalps, skins, and the stories of the lamas in the monasteries. Mm-hmm. We didn't have any difficulty in getting a perfectly rational explanation for all these phenomena.
This was the trip that was financed by the World Book Encyclopedia, isn't it?
Yes, my last expedition was essentially scientific one, carrying out high-altitude physiological research. But one of our programs was to examine this business of the abominable snowman. Mm-hmm. And World Book Encyclopedia financed the whole project.
Mm-hmm. Now let's get back to the list of people and things for your initial reaction. What about women mountain climbers?
Oh, I think some of these women mountain climbers are extremely good. I have climbed with women climbers in New Zealand. Mm-hmm. One girl we climbed with was a very, very good climber indeed. I don't know that there are many women climbers who have done, there are some, but not too many, who are capable of leading on difficult climbs, but there are many of them who are capable of going anywhere that a man can. Mm-hmm. Some women climbers have a great neatness of movement, great balance, and a great deal of confidence, and they can be extremely good.
What about George Mallory?
Well, George Mallory really is what I would call the man of Everest. He was the man that did the original examination of the possible routes onto Mount Everest. He was completely obsessed with the mountain. He was a remarkable man, really. He writes magnificently about it. And I think George Mallory did more to interest people in the whole question of Everest than anybody ever has done. Of course, the fact that he died on the mountain in his final attempt on it rather tends to make it Mallory's mountain.
Mm-hmm. What about Sir John Hunt?
Oh, I think Sir John Hunt is the most remarkable leader I've ever had anything to do with. John Hunt is a very competent mountaineer, but this really is the least important aspect of it. He has great powers of leadership. He can inspire you to work very hard indeed. I think his main flair, and I think this is a great quality of leadership, is his ability to make you feel that your part in the expedition is of prime importance, even though it may appear as though you're not doing the more dramatic task. John Hunt did have the power to make each man feel that what he was doing was of vital importance, as it was, but still it's not everybody that can convey that to the members of a party.
Mm-hmm. Now what about astronaut John Glenn?
Well, I have the greatest admiration for John Glenn. Mm-hmm. I'm less impressed, I'm impressed enough, but less impressed by the fact of his courage, which goodness alone knows he has. More, I've been impressed by the calm, efficient way in which in the conditions in that capsule he can operate so effectively and so efficiently. I think this is really the remarkable thing. There are many men who have the courage to do dramatic feats. I don't think we have any shortage of men of this nature, but there are not too many who are able to carry out a feat like that with the calm, precision, and common sense that Glenn displayed.
Mm-hmm. Sir Vivian Fuchs.
Well, Sir Vivian Fuchs is a man of tremendous dogged determination. I think that's the thing that strikes me most about him. He's a very strong man physically, And this is carried on into his, I think, approach to things. He's very, very determined, very perhaps, he's stubborn in what he does, but he takes a lot of turning back. He does carry on, and he gets there in the end.
Mm-hmm. And Tenzing Norgay.
Well, I think Tenzing Norgay, my sort of opinion, is clouded greatly by affection more than anything else.
Mm-hmm.
Tenzing is a charming personality, and I think really he has been quite remarkable. After all, he started from very, very simple beginnings, just as a Sherpa tribesman. He was born in a little village of Tami, but due to his, he always was very strong and very forceful. He rose up through the ranks of Sherpa porter up to sort of a high altitude Sherpa porter. He became a tiger, which means that he carried loads to over 26,000 feet. And then he actually more or less graduated to the ranks of being one of the climbing members of the party, which very, very few Sherpas had ever done before. Of course, he performed magnificently with the Swiss on their assault in 1952, and then with us he climbed magnificently in the final assault. But you know, although he's had all this adulation from his own people and tremendous respect throughout the world, he still has the same charm and the same easy manner that he had before.
What is he doing now?
He's the chief instructor in a mountain school in Darjeeling, a school formed by the Indian government.
Mm-hmm.
And but not only, this is really only one of his sort of the things he does. His main job is he does talk a lot around India, and he's one of the people who's doing as much as anybody to inspire the young Indian to physical effort and physical endeavor. And mm-hmm. they're showing this. The Indians, of course, have been, for the first time, have been flocking to their mountains in the Himalayas and have been doing some excellent mountaineering.
Finally, Sir Edmund, let me ask you this. Suppose a young person came to you and asked whether or not he should attempt to climb mountains, just like that. Would you give him any advice about whether he should or he shouldn't? In other words, if he just wanted to do it for a lark, what would you tell him?
Well, I wouldn't, if he just wanted to do it for a lark, I don't think I'd probably give him very much good advice.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that only it's for the person themselves to discover whether they want to climb mountains or not. The same would apply to my own children. Although, because I'm interested in mountains and my wife is, we would be inclined to subject our children to a diet of camping and tramping and mm-hmm. A certain amount of the outdoor life, yet I would not attempt to persuade my children to take an interest in the more technical or more dangerous aspects of mountaineering unless they wish to do so themselves. I think this is a thing that you have to get to like, and once you like it, you just have to go as far as you personally feel you want to go. You know, in mountaineering, there's only, I suppose, 0.5% of people do really difficult climbing. The rest of them get just as much pleasure out of tramping over hill country, climbing modest mountains, camping out in the woods, and all the rest of it. This is all a part of expedition life.
Mm-hmm.
And the vast number of people who do this are not interested in doing the really technical tooth and nail aspect. I believe this is a healthy way to be. I think that people should first learn to love the mountains and the outdoors, and then, if they wish, get to grips with the problems of a steep rock and difficult ice.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Sir Edmund Hillary.